Asya Jnana Anjana Chalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kakamayam Dadati Sapadandikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakjatam Sarvanaranarthanritam Namsajivam Sadvaitam Savadhuram Paryanasaitam Krishna Chaitanya Deva Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sarvana Lalita Shri Vishakhamritamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Neelavandhu Jagatpate Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaurabhaktavrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Namo Vishnu Padaya Vishnu Parishvaya Vakare Srimati Radhanatha Swami Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Parishvaya Vakare Srimati Bhaktivedanta Namaste Saraswati Devi, Gauravani Prashadani, Nimishu Shukavati, Pashtadha Vishwa. Gopgurtu Vachalam, Namaste Devi, Yatrapada Mahamande, Shri Guru, Vata Parvani, Mato, Shri Chaitanya Ishwarani. Thank you all. So today we will be the final dose of medicine. Final dose of medicine which will fully cure Arjuna's disease. So we have to see whether our disease is cured or not. Arjuna's disease will be cured. Krishna's instructions are so wonderful and so beautiful that if one deeply contemplates on them, understands them, and one is non-envious, by this time the living entity will actually willingly surrender to the Supreme Personality of God, willingly take Sharanagati Prapannam of the Supreme Lord and say, O Lord, from now on I am yours, I surrender to you. That is the expected output which we will hear very soon today in the verses to come. So if you are not reaching there, then we have to work again, go back to the beginning. Okay, until we become convinced body, mind, intelligence, words, that our life needs to be dedicated to the service of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And only in that way, all our illusion will be dispelled. And only in that way, we can actually achieve the heart's innermost desire, which is for true, eternal happiness, bliss, peace. It seems to be so elusive. So we go through verses from verse 67 onwards, which is more or less the concluding part. As we discussed in the last class, in verses 65 and 66, the Lord repeats his conclusive message to Arjuna. wherein he essentially summarizes the conclusion of the Bhagavad Gita, and he emphatically tells to Arjuna that, Arjun, for your benefit, I am repeating summarily my supreme instruction to you. And I am telling you this because you are very dear to me and I really, really wish good for you. Ishtosi ni dridam gidi. Not just my friend, but I really feel for you. I want you to not miss the central point of what I am trying to tell you, even though I told you so many instructions. And he essentially gives two verses. In verse number 65, the Lord summarizes the whole process of taking shelter of him by giving four methods: Manmana, Bhavamad Bhakto, Madhyachi, Maam Namastu. If you want to come to me, just follow these four. And through these, you can take full shelter of me. And if you follow these four, you will certainly come to me. But in case you are doubting, if I just do these four, what will happen to me? Because so many other things I have to do also, which are my duties. What if I fall short there? Krishna is telling in verse 66, don't worry. If you take full shelter of me like this, I will ensure that you are free from all sinful reactions. Sarva dharman paritya. You don't have to worry about any other dharma if you are fully surrendered to me. Because within surrender to me, all other dharmas are automatically included. Because I am the root of all existence. I am the original supreme person. So when you completely worship me and take shelter of me, automatically all other duties are fully performed. Don't worry about anything else. Even if there is any shortcoming, even if there is any mistake, I will manage it. Aham tvam sarva papibhyo mukshayishyami. Mashuchah, do not worry. Do not be in anxiety that there will be any shortcoming. So Krishna is giving his final assurance to Arjuna. Okay, we are clear? So we will read 67 onwards. Now the Lord has completed the instruction. Now the Lord is going into a section of verses where the Lord is telling, I told you all this secret message. Now please hear from me about this message, how you should treat this message that I have given to you, this topmost secret. Idam te na tapaskaya, na bhaktaya kadachana, na chashu shushve tvacham. Nacha maam yo abhya suryati. This confidential knowledge may never be explained to those who are not austere or devoted or engaged in devotional service, nor to one who is envious of me. Krishna says, even though this knowledge I have given for the benefit of everybody, now that I have told you this supreme secret, but still, don't give this knowledge to these four kind of people. Those who are not austere, na atapaskaya, jo tapa nahi karta, those are not austere. Which means those who are not willing to endure any hardships for spiritual elevation. Why? Useless. Because this is not some armchair philosophy that you listen to like some film songs in a rocking chair for some entertainment. No. This knowledge is about transformation. And transformation requires tapasya. Speaking tapasya is changing from shirt and pant to dhoti and kurta. Transformation. Yes, so transformation requires some austerity. Correct? Is it not? Is it easy to become spiritual? It is simple, but it is not easy. Why? Because we have to put in some effort. So, person who is not willing to discipline himself and undergo some austerity, is no point telling him. Kuch nahi hoga. Correct? It's like putting water on a inverted pot. Put as much water as you put, everything will flow off. You open like this, there's nothing inside. Na atapaskaya, na abhaktaya. If somebody is not devoted to me, also no point. He who is not devoted to me, who is not engaged in devotional service, or who is envious of me. So the Lord essentially saying, explain this knowledge to somebody who is my devotee. And what is the opposite of a devotee?
Not devotee.
Non devotee.
And what is the essential characteristic of a non devotee? It's mentioned in this verse. Answer is in the translation.
Yes.
So the Lord is saying, do not give this knowledge of mine to somebody who is envious of me. Maam cha maam yo abhyasuyati. Abhyasuyati means he who is envious of me. Correct? Why you should not give knowledge of Krishna to somebody who is envious? We discussed this long time back. Anybody remembers? Yes, Ravi?
The person may not believe.
May not believe? Okay, what else? May not believe is true.
It will cause more harm for him.
It will cause him harm. Why will it cause him harm? Very simple. If you really don't like somebody, and if I come to you and say, you don't like it. Don't say me, yeah. You feel very bad. Anyway, I didn't expect an answer, I'm just joking. Okay, so if you really hate somebody and somebody is glorifying that person in front of us, and we are like always eager to criticize him. If you're envious of him, you always you just wish bad for him. But somebody comes and says, he's so nice. Nobody like him. He's so kind. He's so well-mannered. Our heart is from inside. And what will happen in such a situation? We will? Will pleasant words come out from our mouth? That person will be repelled by that message. And in fact, he will react with criticism and offense. Yes? Saying you go to give him medicine and he is going to slap you back. So no point. You cannot give the message to somebody who is envious, because the essential final message of the Bhagavad Gita is surrender to God. How can you tell surrender to God to somebody who is envious of God? Doesn't make sense, right? He's not going to accept. Instead of accepting, he will criticize. And when he criticizes, he goes further away from God. Yes? Rather than coming close to God, it goes further away. That is why even though bhakti is the most simplest and the highest, it is not offered to everybody. That is why Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita a few times repeatedly says, Arjuna, I am telling you this secret because you are my devotee and you are not envious of me. Anasuyave, non-envious. 2-3 times throughout the Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, and he is repeating this now. Before this, at least twice he has said. Okay, homework, find out well. Okay. Whoever tells me accurately those two verses, I will give them a book free. The new book which has come from Bombay for the Journey of Self-Discovery course that we are about to do. Got a bag of books. Vasu Prabhu helped us bring. So whoever will answer that question correctly, find out those verses from the Bhagavad Gita other than this, where the Lord says, I will tell you this knowledge because you are not envious of me and you are my devotee. If you find out those two verses, the first person who finds out, you can WhatsApp also, whoever finds out first.
Okay? Sure about time.
No, I'm not going to answer.
No.
I just give peace. Okay? So we find out, no problem. It's not very difficult questions. Okay? At least two places very clearly. If you find the right verses, I give you the book free. The first person. Okay, so let's move on. So you are clear, right? Cannot be envious, okay? You do know? Find out. So basically the Lord is saying, don't give this knowledge. Normally you think God wants everybody to run the Bhagavad Gita. Why God is saying don't give to this? Because the sad reality of this world is not everybody can receive the medicine. Some persons will have an opposite effect. Even though they are sick, when the medicine is given to them, rather than nicely accepting the message of the medicine, they will either throw it away or they will abuse the doctor, or they react in such a way that actually it will be detrimental to them rather than. And when we speak about the glories of the Lord and somebody says offensive, it is not even good for us. We also don't want to hear criticism of the Lord. Yes? It's not good for us to hear criticism. Like Shishupal, right? Remember we discussed about the episode of Shishupal. In the Rajasuya Yajna, when Krishna was being glorified as the person worthy of Agra Puja, Shishupal couldn't take it. He stood up and vomited unendingly criticism of the Lord. And those saintly souls who were sitting there couldn't tolerate it. They immediately closed their ears. Said, oh, in fact, Nakul, he threw his sword and he said, I'm going to chop off the tongue. Something like that. Nakul or Sahadeva. So Krishna is saying, na atapaskaya, na abhaktaya, na ashushu shrave, he who is not willing to render service, and nurture mam yo abhyasuyati, he who is envious of me. Now in the next verse, the Lord gives a very, very beautiful message. Yatidam paramanguyam, madbhakteshu abhidhasyati. Bhakti mayim param kritva, mame vaishyate samshayah. Very, very hope-giving verse. For one who explains this supreme secret to the devotees, pure devotional service is guaranteed. And at the end, he will come back to me. So on one side the Lord says, whom to not explain. And second is, whom to explain. So don't explain to the envious, but explain to those who are devotees. Because this message is to help devotees to develop pure devotion. And he who will explain the supreme secret to his devotees, the Lord says, guaranteed they will develop pure devotional service and they will come back to me. Do you trust Krishna's guarantee? Trust Krishna's guarantee? Yeah? Okay. Many people in this world give promises, but we cannot trust that promise. Why? Why we cannot trust everybody's promise? We can trust somebody's promise only if there are two ingredients. One is, he must be sure of his intention. That he really intends or he means what he says. Second is, he must have a capacity to fulfill the promise. Correct? Both, right? Are needed, right? intention and capacity. One of them is missing problem. He has intention. I really want to give Ravi 10 million ringgit. Prabhuji, kuch bhi. Because he knows I don't have that capacity. So I can give, and I genuinely want to give. I don't have capacity. Nice thought, Prabhu. Very good, nice thought, but I felt good about it, but so that's only half of the story. The other half is to have capacity. Sometimes you may have a capacity, but you may not have any intention. Can you give me an example of such people? Politicians. They have capacity, but they have no intention. Not everybody, yeah. Wonderful politicians. I personally admire our Prime Minister, India's Prime Minister, as one such person. So, intention and capacity, both are very important. And Krishna has both the intention. Why? Because he is the well-wishing friend of each and every living entity. Is he not? There is no reason to say, no, I favor Suraj, I don't like Ashu. No reason, right? Because both are his children. Why will he favor one over the other? In fact, he has said earlier in the Bhagavad Gita, I love everybody equally, I am not even Parshat for anybody. But when somebody comes to me, I rush to help him. And capacity, who can doubt Krishna's capacity to help? Yes? In fact, that's what Krishna is telling Arjuna, right? I have already decided to finish this battle and you all will live and the others will die by my power, by my capacity, by my plan. My request to you is become my instrument. So Krishna's capacity is not in doubt. No matter how powerful the opposite force is, once Krishna decides, that's all. And that's why Krishna is known as Satya Sankalpa. One of Krishna's name is Satya Sankalpa. When we take Sankalpa, Sankalpa means we decide. If Ashwin is growing up, then he decide, I will become. What do you want to become when you grow up?
He
is assigned to your task. So whatever, somebody says, I want to be astronaut. So, when we think of something, it doesn't mean it gets achieved. Long gap is there between our intention. Lot of effort has to go into execution before the attainment happens. And that also may happen, may not happen. But for Krishna, because he is the controller of everything, all the energies are always acting based on his desire. As soon as he decides, you should consider it as good as done. Understand? For us, we have to endeavor to fulfill something. Krishna doesn't have to endeavor. Parasya shaktir vividhaiva shruyate swabhaviki jnana bala kriyacha. The scriptures say. Swabhaviki. Swabhaviki means very naturally. Jnana bala. All energies are acting. Just he desires. Everything starts. His energies start arranging everything to make sure it happens. That's all. Correct? You understand? Just like a very, very rich, powerful man who says, today I feel like eating vegetable biryani. He just says casually. His energies, who are his servants and other, they just hear. They just hear quickly, they go to market, buy this. He comes for lunch, hey, biryani is ready, how we found out? I didn't have to do anything. Biryani is there for lunch, you understand? When the Lord wishes, his energy is immediately going to action. And his energies nobody can counter, either material or spiritual. They are all powerful. Correct? Any other obstacle come, they will either blow the obstacle or go around the obstacle. They will not stop. So Krishna is Satya Sankalpa. His desire can never be foiled. So when Krishna says, I guarantee, you should take his guarantee very, very seriously. So when he says I guarantee, it really means he is guaranteeing. So here he is guaranteeing. What is guaranteeing? If you explain the supreme secret to his devotees, pure devotional service is guaranteed. He has both the intention and the capacity. And in the end, he will come back to me. Okay. So this is one of the most easiest way to achieve pure devotional service and to go back to Krishna. And the next verse, the Lord will make it even more clear. Let's read the next verse, then we'll discuss a little bit more on this point. Actually, I was very, very surprised when I read the next verse, the first time when I read the next verse. Let's read. Najatasman manushyeshu kashchin me priyakrittamah bhavita nacha me tasmat anya priyataro bhuvi. Translation: there is no servant in this world more dear to me than he. This he is who? The he is who? What Krishna said in the previous verse? Correct. Shri Mata Prabhu is explaining. What are you saying? That he, Krishna is referring to, is he who is explaining the message of the Bhagavad Gita amongst the devotees. He is referring to that person. He says he will achieve pure devotional service. When he is explaining the Gita, he may not have achieved pure devotional service. He says, if he explains, I will give pure devotion to him and I will ensure he goes back to Godhead. And he says, there is no servant in this world more dear to me than he, nor will there ever be one more dear. Hare Krishna. See, dear servants of the Lord have come. Correct? You understand the profundity of this statement. It's a very, very big thing. He's not just saying this person is dear. He's saying with such emphasis that this person is dear to me, he's saying nor will there ever be someone more dear. So what is the Lord telling us? The Lord is telling us this is the most easiest way to become dear to the Lord. You understand? You agree or not? Agree means logically. Agree means whether you agree or not doesn't matter. It is like this. If Krishna is saying it is like this, but do we understand what the Lord is saying? If the Lord is saying, don't explain the supreme knowledge to the non-devotees, but explain it to my devotees, and he who explains to my devotees, he will attain pure devotional service and come back to me. Not only that promise, he is saying that person is very, very, very dear to me in this world. Why? Because in this world he is helping other living entities to also attain me. He is not selfish. Okay, I found out the way. Now I will escape from the prison. So he is saying, okay, I found the way. Why only I should go out? Let me also help others to go out. So he is being like a good brother. The house is burning and all the family members are stuck, and you find that there is one door which can go out where there is an easy way to escape. Will you just quietly go yourself? Bye. Nowadays you cannot see many people like this. Okay. So he goes on to other rooms to find everybody else. Come. I know the way out. Follow me. This is the way to escape from this samsara dava nala, this burning fire of samsara. Yes? He is actually doing a great service to his parents. Is it not? parents will say, oh, you are so nice, you saved. Not only you came out, but you brought whoever of your brothers who listened to you. Of course, not everybody will listen. Some of them will say, why I should listen to you? I'll sit in this room only. So how to help? They cannot be helped. Why? Because they are envious of the message. Actually, they are not just envious of the message, they are actually envious of the original messenger, who is Krishna. So they are not listening. Why should I surrender? Who is Krishna? Krishna has to prove to them how Krishna is all good, how Krishna, whatever he did, is correct. Then I will consider. So Krishna is not interested in giving his application to each of us and scrutinizing. No, no. He doesn't need our certificate. Okay, we need his certificate. So Krishna, out of his mercy, is exhorting us to accept this message. The Lord is saying that if you want to be very dear to me and you want to surely come to me, you want to surely achieve your devotional service, then two things you must do. What are the two things? What is the one thing? Explain the knowledge of the Bhagavad Gita to my devotees. So there is one more thing. There is one more thing. There is one more thing. Yes. To be able to give the knowledge to others, first you must understand yourself. I mean, that is preparation, right? You see, I want to be teacher, I want to be teacher. But I'll not attend school. Myself, but I want to be teacher. How you can be teacher if you have not learned the subject yourself? So it's an implied thing. I'm just emphasizing. It's an implied thing. But to be able to explain the supreme secret, first one has to understand the supreme secret. And if you want to teach the supreme knowledge to others, at least you must be a sincere practitioner of the knowledge yourself in your own life. Not that you are, when you say big things, Bhagavad Gita in your life, you are a cheater and a crooked person. Saturday 4 to 5, Bhagavad Gita, 6 to 7, even Bansar. Then how to preach? Okay, then how to preach? I said, Prabhuji, I saw you. What were you doing there? So, people will take our message seriously only one if we understand the subject and they see us seriously trying to lead our life according to the message. We may not have achieved perfection. That's okay. That's okay. Krishna did not put that. Did he say that you have to be a pure devotee first? Did Krishna put that condition? No. Did he put the condition? No, right? He simply said, he who explains this supreme secret to the devotees. First thing you must understand, you yourself will not understand the supreme secret until you become a devotee. Okay, and that is precisely why the Lord says in the previous verse, don't explain this to the non-devotee. You will not understand. So first thing implied in explaining the supreme secret means you have understood the supreme secret, means you have become a devotee. To some extent, at least faithful, at least not envious. Understand? That is the minimum qualification to become a devotee. Faith and not being envious. You agree, Sri Madhavuru? Correct? At least, if you don't have faith, how can you be a devotee? If you are envious, obviously you are not a devotee. How to be envious of God and say you are a devotee? Because devotee wants to serve the Lord. How can you want to serve somebody you are envious of? It doesn't make sense, right? Or how can you be a servant of somebody whom you have no faith in? Not possible. So that's the absolute minimum. And Krishna throughout the Bhagavad Gita speaks about this faith and this non-enviousness as an absolute minimum. That's why in the previous verse the Lord says, don't explain to the non-faithful. Don't explain to the envious. Don't explain to those who are not interested in developing a relationship with me. Which is na abhaktaya, the Rajana. So this is actually such a How many of you think this is a big encouraging statement? You agree? Why you're not enthusiastic? Enthusiastically put your hand up. It is actually a big encouragement. And the Lord is actually giving us an easy way. And Srila Prabhupada would often repeat this. And he would say, this is the easiest way to get recognized by the Lord. Correct? To get recognized by the Lord. Learn and teach. Even if you are not fully expert. Of course, I am also not expert. But because we are greedy to get mercy of the Lord. Try according to our capacity. At least the minimum we should understand from the Bhagavad Gita. Minimum. What is the minimum we should understand before we can speak Bhagavad Gita?
And
the minimum we should understand is essentially we have to understand the conclusion. Even if all the details we do not remember, the conclusion is one has to surrender to the Lord and render service to Him. Which means 65 and 66. Wahi agar samajh mein nahi aaya to the secret is lost, no? Karma fal tyag is included within surrender, but it is only one component. That is included. But karma phala tyag by itself will not give you bhakti. Karma phala tyag will take you to jnana, but by itself will not give you bhakti. But within bhakti, karma phala tyag is there. Within bhakti, jnana is there. All these things are automatically included within bhakti. So, if you forget everything else, it is okay. Bhagavad Gita, you must understand this. I'm going to say 2-3 sentences. Make sure you fully understand this. If these few things you are not clear about, that means you have not understood the actual conclusion of Bhagavad Gita. Okay? Hear very attentively. Few basic simple points. One, I am not this body, I am a spiritual soul. Point one. Point two, as a spiritual soul, I am a part and parcel of Krishna. Which are very intimately related with Krishna. Correct? You are either making notes or mentally making notes, whatever. Yeah? Very, very important. I am not this body, I am a spiritual soul. Second, I am a part and parcel of Krishna. Third, I am in a miserable situation now. Because I have forgotten my relationship with Krishna. Very, very important. Yes? Correct? That's why you are miserable. Those who are extremely miserable, they don't know that they are miserable. Those who admit they are miserable, that means they are less miserable. That is the nature of illusion or moha. Okay, so that's point number three. Fourth is, I have to re-establish my relationship with Krishna by 18.65. Manmana bhagavad bhakto madhya jima mumaskuru mame vaishami satyam te pratijane priyoshime. By becoming a devotee and by practicing devotional service, I will have to re-establish my relationship with the Lord. And the last is 66, that if I simply do this, all other things will automatically be taken care of. I don't have to worry about anything else. Okay, was that the fifth point? Yes. If I surrender, surrender is 55, manmanava madbhakta madhyaji on surrender. And if I surrender, I don't have to worry about anything else. Krishna will take care of everything. Everything includes not just spiritual life, even my material life, Krishna will take care of. Even my children's education, Krishna will take care of. My daughter's marriage, Krishna will take care of. My loan, Krishna will take care of. Me, my health, Whatever Krishna will take care of. There is Krishna's insurance policy, you don't have to worry. That is the... So if you know this much clearly and you believe in this much clearly, this much knowledge is the actual supreme secret. All other things, even if you forget, not that I'm asking you to forget, even if you forget, that will not disqualify you from sharing the supreme secret. You may not understand the intricacies of karma yoga, jnana yoga, ashtanga yoga. It's okay. Not that it's great. It's okay. But these five, was it five things I told? These five things, you cannot falter in any one of them. If you miss any one of them or you have a wrong understanding of any one of them, you will not be able to share the supreme secret. Okay? So how many of you, put your hands up, understand and have faith in these five instructions? Honestly, yeah? If you are not understood, it's okay. Okay. Then, thank you. That means two things. That means my class is successful. So many years, finally. Okay. And second thing is, you are already qualified to follow this instruction. You don't have to wait 20 years before you start sharing Bhagavad Gita with others. Sharing this knowledge with devotees doesn't mean organizing an academy on Saturday, having a class like this. No. Suraj is going and telling his friends about the knowledge and encouraging them to come and study and explain to them. Correct, Prabhu? Is that is also following this verse? Correct? Vinalji is already having a class where sometimes she is struggling to answer questions. Yes, she struggles sometimes, right? Sometimes students also say, kya answer nahi aata hai. But in spite of that, she is determined to give them Krishna consciousness. Correct? Actually, it is more difficult to explain the subject when you are not very expert in the subject, but still you want to. It's an embarrassing thing. Is it not? It requires genuine courage and compassion. She is willing to do that austerity. Yes. Because the main thing people think when somebody says you explain this, no, I don't know enough. How can I explain enough? But actually all that is needed to share this knowledge is to understand at least these five things, and the second thing is humility. I need to be humble. Humble means I know this much. If I don't know, fine, I will find out and tell you next time. It's okay. Why you have to pretend that I am like, you know, Arjun, I just understood, now I can repeat everything and explain everything perfectly. It's okay. Nobody can claim to be that. Even the material science, no scientist can say, I know everything about everything. Correct? They know a little bit about... Sorry, they know a lot about a little bit. Correct? A PhD is like that. People generally have a tendency that PhD means they know a lot. No. They know a lot about something very small. This is their very, 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 very specific field of study. And when you become a super, super, super specialist, you know everything about nothing. So small. So nobody can actually have the whole knowledge of understanding. So the point is, these five things are very important. If you have an understanding and faith in these five, you have basically grasped the message of the Gita. You are qualified to practice devotional service, and you are qualified to share devotional service to those who are not envious. And those who are willing to lend a ear. Okay. So again, I am taking this opportunity to encourage all of you, according to your capacity and inspiration, to somehow or the other implement this verse in your life. You can open a class in your house. You have three teachers, three pandits. If you have any doubt, you can ask Ashwin. Correct, Ashwin? Will guide, no? So, please do this. And the Lord gives intelligence. That is my experience. The Lord always gives us the intelligence. Sometimes we are also put onto the spot where we are. I'll just tell one story to you. My small experience. Can I? So I'm just sharing this so you get some perspective. Once I was accompanying, this was when I was staying in the ashram as a brahmachari person. I'm very, very new. And one senior brahmachari, he took me to a particular place to preach. He was cultivating some boys in a engineering college in Maharashtra, so I forgot the name of the place also. So we were staying there for a few days and we decided to go there and do that class. So as we were walking out in the evening, he told me, you see there, and I had just completed my engineering at that time, just completed worked for some time in our ashram. You see this? That is the hostel, college and the hostel. He said, you go there and start a Bhagavad Gita class. I just told you that. And said, I'm going somewhere else. And I'll come. And then I'll come and see you there. So he told me, he went and I went for. I had no idea what to do. You see, just go there. I don't know anybody there. I don't know one person. I have never given a class. I have not thoroughly studied the Bhagavad Gita yet. I know only the five things. That much I know. But I said, okay, he has instructed me, so I must do something. I didn't know what to do. So I was just walking towards the college. And I came there. And I was just walking through the aisles, not knowing what I should do. How to just go and start Bhagavad Gita class. You understand the situation. I just imagine that you just walk in. And I'm in a dhoti kurta. At that time, with a shaved head. With the shikha, because I was living like a monk. But to cut a long story short, I just went and knocked on the door and went into one hostel room. Just nothing, don't know anybody, nothing. Just struck a conversation, started talking to them something about Gita, whatever would come to me. I don't even remember what I spoke. I actually don't remember. And spoke to them something about the Gita, they got a bit interested, then they called somebody. Then we had a group of 10-15 boys, out of the blue, just got some people, sat together, discussed Bhagavad Gita for 10-15 minutes, convinced them that we should have a class in this particular place. They agreed. And I came out of the college with 15 people following me. Following me means they just came to send me. And by that time, the picture returned. Now, after that whole episode, I was thinking, my God, what happened? This is unimaginable. You understand, from an ordinary sense, it is practically unthinkable. I'm thinking, are aise kaise ho gaya? And I just was having faith in the Lord and the instruction that it will work out. How it will work out, I didn't know. Whether I have enough knowledge, I was sure I didn't know. But the Lord arranged in such a way that He got it done to me at that point in time. And I was there, and after that I never gave the class because all those people were supposed to attend the other proposed program. And I believe that they started and it went on. But the reason I am telling this story is how, if we simply have faith and a sincere desire to share the message, the Lord will get things done through us miraculously in such ways that we ourselves will be wondering how this happened. And this has not just happened once, this has happened many, many times, I have seen. Many, many times. So I am not going to the other stories now. But the point is, don't worry. Because we are trying to do the work of the Lord, the Lord's blessings and the blessings of all the great souls in the parampara is with us. So even if there are shortcomings, things will work very, very wonderfully. When this happened, I was only 21 years of age. Correct? Okay. Interesting, right? In a far away place where I don't know, just and not that this has happened with me, this has happened with many, many others. I'm not telling that my case is something extraordinary. Many of Prabhupada's disciples did something similar on a much, much bigger scale. Mine was a very small scale. And many, many devotees have done something similar. But the point is, for me, when I went through that, I realized, wow, this is something extraordinary. I never thought that you can just walk into some place and just, without knowing anybody, be able to do something like this. So it was very, very encouraging. So the reason why I am telling you this is, if you know these five things and you want to become dear to the Lord, please do not be worried because of so many shortcomings in ourselves. Just reach out and everything else will work out. Okay? We will move on. Text 17. Adhyeshate cha yatimam dharmyam sambhadam avayoho jnanayatnena tenaham ishtasyam iti me matih. And I declare that he who studies this sacred conversation of ours worships me by his intelligence. Krishna is saying, even if you simply study, it's not even practice, even if you simply study this conversation, I consider he has worshipped me with his intelligence. And what happens to him? Next verse. Shraddhavana suryascha
Shraddhavana
Shrunuyadapi yo naraha Suvapi mukta shubhan lokan
Suvapi mukta shubhan lokan
Prapnuyat punya karmana
Prapnuyat punya karmana.
And one who listens with faith and without envy. Again, repetition of the same. Faith, remember, we mentioned these two words, right? The Lord is repeating again and again. Faith and without envy becomes free from sinful reactions and attains to the auspicious planets where the pious dwell. So the Lord is saying two more things. Of course, the best is to understand the secret and teach to others. But some people are just curious. I want to find out about the Bhagavad Gita. They are not interested in becoming devotees. They may not be so envious, they may be neutral, but they are just curious. Let me find out. So they try to understand the Bhagavad Gita, but they may not actually practice it. Such people also, Krishna is saying, I consider they worship me with their intelligence. But if you listen with faith, some people are curious, but they may not have faith. That also is considered worship. But those who listen with faith, Shraddhavan, Anasuya, and those who are not envious, simply by listening to the Bhagavad Gita with faith, not even practicing, simply by listening to the Bhagavad Gita with faith, one becomes free from all one's sins and attains after this life to higher Swarga planets where the pious living entities. Do you understand this? If you simply listen to Bhagavad Gita with faith, you will be free from your sins and you will attain the Shubhan Lokan, the auspicious planets where the Punya Karmadam people go. Those who perform lot of Punya, they go to the Swarga. The same Swarga, no need to do so many Punya. Simply attend Bhagavad Gita classes. Listen with faith. Even if you don't practice, not that I'm telling you to not practice. Even this is just to glorify Bhagavad Gita. This is not to encourage you to not practice. So just imagine if you simply listen, if you get so much, if you practice, how much you will get. Okay, so this is to be taken like that. Okay. If you simply listen with faith, you will be free of sin and achieve the heavens. So as of now, all of you have already attained that. Okay? Correct? Because I am confident you all listened with faith. You become free of your sins and you will definitely achieve higher planets. At least, already in our pocket, as of this day. Okay. Sins will be destroyed, we will go to heaven. So let others do so many punya as we have done. Just by attending Gita class and understanding and hearing the Bhagavad Gita with faith, we have already achieved. Huh? No, I am not going there. You can go.
Prabhuji will get higher planet.
I do not want to go to any higher planet. So Krishna says in the sixth chapter, the Lord says, those who practice even a little bit of yoga, a little bit, very easily they go to heaven. But those who are yogis are never interested to go to heaven. They want to go to the spiritual world to serve the Lord directly. They don't want to waste their time in heaven. Why be busy with Indra and Ramba and Roshi? You want?
No,
right? Waste of time. Better we continue to study and preach Bhagavad Gita. I want to follow the previous verse. This verse is for those who have some faith and are willing to hear. They will achieve that result. But devotees are not interested in this result. Devotees want something much, much higher. What do they want? What do you want? Yes, we want pure devotional service and we want to attain the Lord. So for that, what we have to do? Study the Gita and teach it to others. Of course, practice also. Then we can achieve the supreme destination at the end of this life itself. So those who are stuck in heaven, we will say bye-bye and I'm on the way. See you. In the Bhagavatam, there is this shloka that the devatas in heaven are offering flowers and worship to those great souls who are preaching Bhagavad Gita and who are going to Vaikuntha. They think, "Arey, mujhe bhi karna chahiye tha. I should have also done. See, I'm stuck in heaven. They are going back to Vaikuntha." Very difficult. Because heaven, there is so much of sense pleasure. To remember Krishna is very difficult. That's why those who are in heaven want to come to earth. Because in earth, there is a bit more sober situation. Correct? You cannot say, "I want to," if you want to seriously study and practice something, you cannot say, I want to go to the dance bar and then sit with my books and study. There's going to be so much distraction. So going to heaven is something like, I'm just giving a crude example. It's like going into a party and saying, "I'm going to seriously diet, I'm going to seriously study." You're in a party, everybody is dancing, loud music. You cannot, right? Heaven is like that. Heaven is like a big material party. So that's not the best place to be for a devotee. The devotees want to be here. Why? Here people are a bit more sober. Here it is more apparent, the miseries of material existence. Heaven one forgets that material life is miserable because the pleasure aspect is so strong, one is overcome with illusion. So the devotee doesn't want to go there. The devotee wants to be here practice, become purified, develop your devotion, goes straight to Vaikuntha. And as he goes past Swarga Lok, Jana Lok, Mahar Lok, Tapar Lok, Satya Lok, those residents, they will offer flowers and worship you as you are going. Indra will worship you. Brahma will also worship you as you are going past, because you are achieving something which even the devatas have not yet attained. Amazing, right? And that's the truth, I am not exaggerating. You can attain something which the devatas also cannot attain. That is why in the scriptures it is said, the devatas in Kali Yuga want to take birth on earth. Why? They are in such a good place. Why they want to come down? We want to go there, but they want to come here. Why? Because they know Krishna has given such an easy formula. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has made it even more easier. Simply by chanting the name of the Lord and sharing this message. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has made it one more step easier. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, the essence of following the Bhagavad Gita is to chant the name of Krishna. Yes? So you chant the name of Krishna and you tell others to chant the name of Krishna.
That's all.
He has made it more simple. Because the essence of the five instructions is to chant the name. That is the conclusion of the five instructions. Correct? So simply chant the name and encourage others to chant the name. Of course, to encourage others, not you have to explain to them. So you still need to know the five things. But it is simplified. Even if you don't know the five things, if you repeatedly chant a name with faith and without envy, you will develop all other things. Nama. Chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Chant and encourage others to chant. If you simply do this, you can achieve the supreme destination which even the devatas cannot attain. So the devatas are saying, why am I wasting so much time? One day of the devatas is 1 year on earth. Yes? One day of the devatas is 1 year of earth. Our Uttarayan is their daytime, our Dakshinayan is their nighttime. This is what scriptures mention. Yes? So their one day is 1 year. So in our 100 years, assuming we live a life of 100 years, is there 3 months only, barely? So if we simply practice this message and follow these instructions, within their 3 months, we are already gone to Vaikuntha. So imagine their frustration. Arey, abhi abhi toh born hua tha. Yeah, and I'm here only, nothing. My situation is same. I'm just dancing and jumping. I have not overcome birth, old age, disease, death, I am still suffering. This person went. He was just born only in Kuala Lumpur, I am in Indra Loka. Devatas are thinking like this. He was staying in Pine Stone Road and Palm Court and I am in Indra Loka and went. Just by going to Pines Gita Academy and for 2 years he heard something and started practicing and then he started his own class and he went.
This is not fair.
I also want to go to earth. Before the Pines Gita Academy classes stop, I want to quickly take birth, attend the classes, and I also want to go, and all my friends in Swargaloka, I also want to say bye-bye. So that is the greed that the devatas have. And this is not my concoction. These are verses in scripture which mention this. I'm not exaggerating. Literally, what I said is literally mentioned in the scriptures. Those who are on their way to Vaikuntha, the higher planets, people worship them and offer them flowers. And they are feeling that we are stuck here, why we have not gone. Verses which say that the devatas are eager to take birth in Bharat Varsha in Kali Yuga. So why we are mentioning all this? Please be convinced that you all in this room right now are actually in the best situation. Actually, if we understand, we are in a better situation than the devatas. And this is the truth, I am not exaggerating this. The day you actually understand this, you will be amazed. The day I understood this, I was very, very amazed. Wow. this far out man. Actually it is far out. In Kali Yuga, to get this particular opportunity to actually understand this message and practice it, and within a very small lifespan of 100 years, one can actually achieve the supreme destination. Isn't that an amazing thing? Yes? And what you have to do? Spend 2 years understanding the Bhagavad Gita, accept just these 5 points, and then share that message with? Very simple. You can still do your job, you can still have your families. By Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, all you have to do is chant the holy name and encourage others to chant the holy name. So please take this message very, very seriously. So with this, the Phalashruti of Bhagavad Gita is over. Okay, these three things. Best is, quickly summarizing, best is you understand and teach this to others, then you are guaranteed going. Guaranteed. If you simply listen or intellectually understand, you worship me with your intelligence, Krishna says. But if you listen with faith, you become free from all sins and you achieve the higher planets. Three levels. Worship with intelligence, basic listening, basic hearing or study. With faith, become free from sins, go to heavens. Actually listen. Practice and teach. Go back to the spiritual world. Clear? So now Lord gives a conclusive statement to Arjuna. Actually not a statement. He gives a conclusive question to Arjuna. Let's see what he says. Sorry, I'll take 10-15 more minutes. Is that okay? Yeah? Last class. So please call it a little bit. Kashchidetam shrutam partha Tvaya ekagrena chetasa Kashchid ajnana ajnana sammoha Pranashtaste dhananjaya. After giving all instructions, the Lord is asking Arjun, O son of Pritha, O conqueror of wealth, have you heard this with an attentive mind? And are your ignorance and illusions now dispelled? Samajh mein aaya kya? Jo main bataya ho. And what is the test, whether you understood or not? Is your illusion dispelled? Because initially you were an illusion. Devatas also got excited. Indra is confirming what we just discussed. He is lamenting and crying why he is not here attending the class. My humble obeisances to him. Okay, so have your doubts in you. Because at the end of the Bhagavad Gita, the expectation is we are very clear. We are very clear with the 5 conclusions, right? For a devotee, these are the 5 conclusions which are very important. So he is asking him, is your ajnana and sammoha destroyed? So let's see what Arjun says. Arjun will give certificate to Krishna at the end of Bhagavad Gita, whether Krishna did the right job. So Arjuna says, Arjuna uvacha, nashto moha smritir lagva,
nashto moha smritir lagva,
vat prasadan mayachuta,
vat prasadan mayachuta,
sitosmi gata sandeha,
sitosmi gata sandeha,
karishye vachanam tava,
karishye vachanam tava.
Arjuna said, my dear Krishna, O infallible one Achyuta, my illusion is now gone. Nashto moha, my illusion is gone. Smritir labdhva, I have regained my memory. Tvat prasada, by your mercy. I have regained, I have lost my memory. I had become illusion for some time, but now I am very clear. I am now firm and free from doubt. Gata sandeha, free from doubt and I am prepared to act according to your instruction. Okay. So this is the expected result after understanding Bhagavad Gita. Okay, two things must happen. All one's doubt and illusion should go. Point number one. And second is, one must become ready to follow the instructions that the Lord has given. In Arjuna's case, what was the instruction?
To fight.
Was it to fight? Was the instruction to fight?
To fight
for Krishna. Not just fight. Fight for Krishna. Don't miss the point. Otherwise, only half mark you get. Strict examiner will get half mark because you say, no, not fight. Duryodhana was also fighting. It was not about fighting, it was about fighting for Krishna. Okay? For us, what does it mean? Nashtomo Sutur Labda. What does it mean? Karishye Vachanam Tava. What does it mean for us? For Arjuna, it meant fighting for Krishna. What does it mean for us? We should now make an effort to engage in Krishna's service. Arjuna is serving him by fighting. We don't have to go and fight. For us, we have to put the principles of Bhagavad Gita into our life. That is following Krishna's instruction. Because what is Krishna's instruction? Man manabhava mad bhakto madhya jimam namaskuru. Now we have to put that into our life. Yes? Oh, I am not worshipping the Lord every day. Let us start worshipping him every day. I am not offering respects to him every day. Let us start offering respects. I am not thinking of the Lord enough. Let me think of the Lord more. How should I think of the Lord more? Chant his name. Hear about him. Even if you are not always here, we are here only on Saturday. Other days you can listen to classes. So many classes are available on the internet. Yes? So manmana you can do. Bhavmat bhakto, render service. So many are rendering service. He is rendering service of recording. Meenalji is rendering service of preaching Bhagavad Gita. Shamiji is rendering service of doing all these arrangements. My good wife Chandrika is rendering service of cooking prasad for all of us for so many years. Of course, she also does her own classes, but she is also doing this, assisting us. She has brought something special also. So, render service in some form or the other. By rendering service, our devotion increases very, very fast, very rapidly we make spiritual. That is guaranteed. By rendering service very well rapidly. If you don't know what service to render, come and ask. What can I do? It's very simple. It's as simple as that. It's not very complicated. You don't have to go in meditation for 100 years to get that. Yeah? It's very simple. Don't complicate more than necessary. So that is how we should practice it in our life. So, Arjuna's doubts are dispelled. Now, the last few verses, which will only take 5 more minutes, is actually Sanjay, who is giving the concluding epilogue, so to say. This epilogue means, after the Bhagavad Gita has been spoken, he is speaking a few words to wind up his narration. Because if you remember, who is narrating the Bhagavad Gita? To Dhritarashtra. Yes, that was the beginning, right? Dharma kshetre kuru kshetre samaveta yutsavah mamakaha pandavashaiva kima purvata Sanjaya. Dhritarashtra is asking Sanjaya, please tell me what my sons and the sons of Pandu did when they assembled together on the holy battlefield of Sanjaya. And then Sanjaya, by the grace of Vyasa, was narrating the whole episode. And Sanjay has just finished narrating the last thing that Arjuna told to Krishna. And now Sanjay is talking back to Dhritarashtra. So let us hear the last few verses of what he is saying.
Sanjay Uvacha.
Sanjay Uvacha.
ಇತ್ಯಹಂ ವಾಸುದೇವಸ್ಯ
ಇತ್ಯಹಂ ವಾಸುದೇವಸ್ಯ
ಪಾರ್ಥಸ್ಯ ಚ ಮಹಾತ್ಮನಃ
ಪಾರ್ಥಸ್ಯ ಚ ಮಹಾತ್ಮನಃ
ಸಂವಾದಂ ಇಮಂ ಅಶ್ರೌಷಂ
ಸಂವಾದಂ ಇಮಂ ಅಶ್ರೌಷಂ
ಅದ್ಭುತಂ ರೋಮಹರ್ಷಣಂ
ಅದ್ಭುತಂ ರೋಮಹರ್ಷಣಂ
ಸಂಜಯ ಸೇಡ್ ಥಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಐ ಹರ್ಡ್ the conversation of two great souls, Krishna and Arjun. And so wonderful is that message that my hair is standing on end. You understand? Roma Harsha. Roma Harsha means the hair standing on end. You can see my hair is standing on end. Because that is the expected result after you hear about Bhagavad Gita. After hearing about this wonderful message, if you are not excited, you are not like this. Krishna has just told you how to escape from the blazing fire of material existence and achieve his lotus feet, achieve eternal life of bliss and love and beauty, and you are that is our mood. Krishna is here. I have to come once more for this person. Not excited. He must be excited. Sanjay was excited. Dhritarashtra was not. Actually, to be honest. Because he was, his moha was still not nashtar. Because he was not a devotee. Because he was not, no, he was actually envious of the Lord and the Lord's devotees. That's why he did not go through the transformation. But Sanjay was a devotee. His hair was standing on that. He was excited. Okay. So we all must be excited to hear the message of the Lord. That's why when we come for Bhagavad Gita class, we must be excited to hear what did the Lord say. Let me find out what's next. Like you are excited for the next episode of a soap opera serial. Next, what happens? Yeah. Okay. So like that. 75. Vyasa prasadat shrutavan etat guhyam aham param yogam yogeshwarat krishnat sakshat kathayata svayam. Why I am so excited? He is explaining. By the mercy of Vyas, I have heard these most confidential talks directly from the master of all mysticism, Krishna, who was speaking personally to Arjun. So excited. Personally, Krishna is telling the topmost knowledge to Arjun, and I heard it by Vyasa's mercy. Yes! I was there live. Like we put on Facebook, no? Yes, I'm here, I'm eating this, I'm doing this, like that. Sanjay is excited. If there was Facebook, he would have immediately put. I was there. I heard it live. Krishna streaming live. Krishna to Arjun, Bhagavad Gita, as it is. Okay? And he's so grateful to his guru Vyas, who made it possible for him. And by the mercy of Vyas, and through the representatives of Vyas, we are getting the same message today. Yes? So we should also be grateful. Rajan samsmritya samsmritya sambadam imam, sorry, yeah, correct. Sambadam imam adbhutam
sambadam imam adbhutam
keshavarjuna yor punyam
keshavarjuna yor punyam
Shami cha muhur muhu.
Shami cha muhur.
Again, his excitement is continuing. O King, as I repeatedly recall this wondrous and holy dialogue between Krishna and Arjun, I take pleasure being thrilled at every moment. Muhur muhu means again and again. Shami, I am being excited and being happy. Wow. What a wonderful summarization of all Vedic knowledge. Wow, so crystal clear the conclusion. This is wonderful. Okay.
Tatcha samsmritya samsmritya Rupam adbhutam harehe Vismayo me mahan rajan Drishyami cha punah punah O King, as I remember the wonderful form of Lord Krishna, I am struck with wonder more and more, and I rejoice again and again. You can see, can you sense his excitement? How excited he is. Drishyami, Drishyami, I'm excited, I'm so happy, wonderful, wonderful. Wow, this was cool. In the true sense, why was it cool? Because it's actually giving coolness to the heart, which is blazing in the fire of material existence. Now he says a very wonderful blessing verse, which is a very wonderful summarization and a very wonderful meditation for all of us. The last verse of Bhagavad Gita. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna
Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna
Yatra Partho Dhanurdhara
Yatra Partho Dhanurdhara
Yatra Shri Vilya Yogutir
Yatra Shri Vilya Yogutir
Duva Nikirma Nirmama
Duva Nikirma Nirmama.
Wherever there is Krishna, the master of all mystics, and wherever there is Arjuna, the supreme archer, there will also certainly be opulence, victory, extraordinary power and morality. That is my opinion. So wherever there is Krishna and his devotee Arjuna, there will definitely be victory, opulence, morality, as well as extraordinary power. Yes. So Krishna is always there. We have to become like Arjuna. So when we become like Arjuna, a devotee, then automatically extraordinary victory, power, morality and opulence will automatically come in our lives. This is a very wonderful meditation. Very wonderful meditation. Whenever I step out of the house, every day I utter this verse. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna, Yatra Partho Dhanurdhara, Tatra Shri Jayo Bhutir Dhruva Nikirma. To make all that we do auspicious, and so that all obstacles can be removed and all auspiciousness will come in all our activities. So it's a very wonderful meditation. Is Rantara Shrimad Bhagavad Gita Ki? Shri Krishna Arjuna ki
Jai,
Vyasa Deva ki
Jai,
Shri Prabhupada ki
Jai,
Samaveda Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki
Jai,
Bhai Gaura Premanandi
ki
Jai. Oh, they are also saying Jai. They are envious of us because they know we are going to make it before them. And that is the truth. So, any questions, any comments?
Prabhuji.
Yes.
Sanjay was able to see the Vishwarupa.
Sanjay was able to see the Vishwarupa. Sanjay was able. Actually, not only Sanjay, by Vyasa's mercy, even Dhritarashtra could see. Any other question? So, you are clear? Is your doubts dispelled? Is your moha dispelled? If not, we can go through it once again. I have no problem. So slowly, slowly. And the faster way is by practicing the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. So I'll let you know, what I'm intending to do over the next few weeks is to discuss some of the practical aspects of Bhagavad Gita. We'll discuss over the next few weeks. And then very soon we will start the course I mentioned about. So I will let you know of the dates, so we can continue our discussions. Namo Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prishaya, Guru Hare, Vimante Vati, Vimante Vati, seek their blessings also on our path back to the Lord's Lotus Feet.